Thank you. Namaste to all yoga seekers across the world. We'll start off with the Shanti Mantra. Repeat after me. Sahana Bhavatu. Sahana Bhunaktu. Saha Viryam. Karavavahai. Tejasvinavadhitamastu. Ma Vidvishavahai. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
In a way, this Shanti Mantra itself conveys the message of yoga. Sahana Vavatu. May we coexist together in harmony. Sahanau Bhunaktu. May we get nourished together. Not that only the teacher gets nourished and students are impoverished. It is saying that may both the teacher and the taught, may everyone get nourished together. Sahaviryam karavavahai. With this nourishment, may we accomplish great things in our lives. We are not ordinary. Every one of us has extraordinary potential. May we realize our potential within. May we all accomplish unimaginable things in our lives. Glorious things in our lives. In this process, Ma Vidvishavahai. May we never despise each other. May we never hate each other. May we coexist in harmony. That is, in essence, the message of yoga. Yoga, yoga, yoga means to connect. To connect, we need two points. Without having two points, there is no meaning of connecting. That connect from where to where, we have to connect. The starting point of connecting, I have to connect from here. This is the starting point. What is this one? Is this an outer casing? Is it me? It's the outer casing, is just a shell. It is not just a shell. And within that one, what is that mind? Mind keeps changing. And today I do a sankalpa, tomorrow vikalpa. I want this one, tomorrow I don't want this one. So, mind also is not that one. And behind that one, manas, beyond that one, is that the buddhi? Buddhi takes a decision. We say that this person doesn't have a buddhi and this person has a buddhi. Even many buddhi people, many so-called intellectual people mislead the community. Can I trust my buddhi? Even beyond that one, my memory. Is that memory, as I am getting older, memory also wanes off. Can I trust my memory? Beyond that one, that when the mind is no longer disturbing, when mind has become very calm, when the mind has become very serene, mind is no more tormenting, and it is not talking about the murcha avastha, it is not the sleep avastha or coma avastha. When the mind has become very calm, then jiva, the soul within, starts functioning. That soul within and jiva, that jiva is nothing but a reflection of Paramatma. The Supreme God, He is there with all positive attributes. This soul starts radiating the divine qualities. The connecting this soul within to the Supreme Lord. This connection is called as yoga. Yoga to bring out the best in you, bring out the divine qualities in you, make yourself that when the divine quality starts expressing, you start becoming like a source of energy for the community, source of inspiration for the community. You, by practicing yoga is not just turning your hands and legs and bending forward and backward. Beyond that one, may the soul within, for that this body has come about. Nourish the soul. May the soul express itself. May it starts radiating the divinity within. And when that connection is established, yoga is said to have been told, is said to have dawned in that person. Initially, I go to different yoga schools. Now our Rotarian, our Raviji, he mentioned, I also belong to that Rotary Club, and we go to many yoga classes, that class, this class. And initially, I go to various classes, and after that, when the yoga dawns, when it is connects, yoga comes to me. Initially, I am going out in seeking the yoga, and when connection is made, then yoga comes to me. It is called as divinity in yoga. Yoga is divine. We have to realize that one. Yoga is not limited to asana, bending and stretching. Many people, they said, if I ask them to come to yoga, they said, sorry, I am not flexible. I am not able to do. I am very old. I used to do when I was a child. And what Shastra is talking about, yoga, you are able to connect. When it connects, the best in you comes out. To do that one, and I need this framework. I can't say that I am not, many people, many Vedantins, they say, we are not body, we are the soul, and we are worried about that one. Without this casing, how can you do? You need a body. Without a body, how can you do the sadhana? The body has to be strong, body has to be healthy. The healthy body, and in Mundaka Upanishad, it is talking about Nayam Atma Balahinena Labhyaha. One who is weak, physically weak, mentally weak, spiritually weak, cannot get the highest. If you want to achieve great things in your life, you have to be physically strong, mentally calm, and spiritually connected. Only the strong person can achieve great things in the life. And in the Shweta Ashwatthara Upanishad says, what are the benefits of yoga? Natasya rogo na jarana mrityu yogagni ayam shariram. Lagutvam, aloluptvam, arogyam. And you feel the lightness, and mind becomes calm, serene, and health improves, and there is no disease, no sign of these problems of the old age, always bubbling with energy. That is the benefit of yoga. The practice of yoga. Yoga helps us to reveal the divinity in us, and the best in us has to come out. Everyone is unique. Everyone is special. Everyone has a tremendous potential in us. And bring out, unleash your potential, and become someone special in the community. Become ordinary is not the purpose of yoga. And becoming like others is not like a purpose of yoga. You are special. You are extraordinary. Bring out your extraordinary potential out. You are not like others. We are not here to imitate others. Every fingerprint is different. Every soul is different. Everyone is special. Everyone is unique. And you express and unleash your uniqueness. That is what is called in the Shastras as called as Mukti or liberation. You becoming yourself is liberation. You becoming somebody, it is not it's a liberation. In Bhagavad Gita, Sri Krishna says, Swadharme nidanam shreya paradharma swanishtita paradharmo bayavaha Swadharme nidanam shreya. Become yourself. If you try to put your steps in the in tune with somebody's steps, then life is fraught with stress, anxiety and depression. You becoming yourself and then you experience the freedom, inner freedom. Now the coronavirus situation, the mental health issue is a big problem across the world. Not only in India, in America, now every day it's clocking nearly 250,000 corona cases every day, nearly 2,500 deaths every day in America, European countries, our India and many parts across the world. Mental health is the biggest challenge. Mental health to overcome that one, settle down within. Come down, settle down, settle down, settle down. When I am so anxious going out, when I am trying to go out, I want to go out to imitate, filled with anxiety. Go within, settle down, settle down, settle down. XP, when you are settled down within, you will find stability in your life. And Vasudeva Kriya Yoga is professes on this dimension of yoga. We enrich yourself to before you enrich others. If you want to enrich your family members, enrich yourself. Like in a aeroplane, they say in case of emergency, put on the oxygen mask onto yourself before you help others. You have to, otherwise there may be two casualties. To enrich your family members, enrich yourself. To enrich the community, enrich yourself. To enrich the nation, enrich yourself. To enrich the world, enrich yourself. Long inhale and longer exhale. We will do some pranayama and asanas. Others will be showing the asana. And we will do early morning in India. It's still early morning. We will do asana. I will show you some asana. You are here. You are sitting. Bend your knees. Lock your toes. Flap your knees. It's good for people with piles problem. Large intestine problem. Colon problem. Feel this. People with uterus sleep problem. Women in antenatal and prenatal conditions, they find this one beneficial. With inhale, raise your hands above your head and see whether you can lean on the side. Feel the side stretch. Energizes the spine. Look at the ceiling up. Other side. Do not lose contact with your smile. Smile on your lips. Feel the stretch. Up, exhale, up, exhale, lean on the side, up, other side, up, and back. Long inhale and longer exhale. Long inhale and longer exhale. Long inhale, longer exhale. Take your neck as back as you can. Relax your neck muscles as you exhale, come forward, inhale back, exhale forward, inhale back, reverse, de-stresses the neck muscles, and back, long inhale and longer exhale, long inhale, longer exhale. And the beneficial pranayama for during the lockdown, this corona period, our vocal cord should be healthy. We will do the Ujjayi pranayama. Like your vehicle doesn't have enough grunt, doesn't have enough horsepower. You are trying to climb 60, 40, 45 degrees mountain and it is struggling to go up. It is struggling such a way. Now when you are inhaling, the sound should be that way. That you are struggling, it is not smooth. Like Like a person is snoring. You hear that person, how that person is snoring. As you're inhaling, you feel the vibration in the vocal cord. People with thyroid problem, parathyroid problem, they find this one beneficial. Thyroid, parathyroid problem, they find this one beneficial. You do three more times. Again. Again. Two more times. Again. Now other way. Now smooth sound like a bumblebee. As you are inhaling, make that sharp sound. It's good for people with vertigo problem, hearing problem. Again. And back. Long inhale and longer exhale. Long inhale. Longer exhale. Long inhale. Longer exhale. Long inhale. And longer exhale. This coronavirus situation, we will energize our own body. Activate, let us activate all the endocrine glands. And you bring your left hand on your chest, right hand on your crown. Chest, the place of the contentment, bliss, joy. Head is the source. The things has to flow from the top to bottom. And the source of enrichment in the crown. Above the crown, visualize the white color orb. Within that one, Varuna is the presiding deity. Within him, Lord Vasudeva, who pervades everywhere, he is pouring down the nectar from the crown. Visualize the ambrosia, nectar, life force flowing down from the crown. Visualize it is going through each and every part of your body. Whole body is getting rejuvenated, re-energized. Your experience, your feeling, you are becoming new altogether. Repeat the mantra. Om Vartu Mandala Madhyastha Shweta Varna Varuna Antargata Shri Vasudeva Bhagavan Mat Sharira Amrita Vrishtya Plavayato. Visualize the flow. Repeat after me. Om Vam, 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 Om Vam. Bring your hands down into Chin Mudra, thumb and index finger together. smile on your lips. Experience the tranquility within, bliss within, joy within. You're in happy for no reason. Chant Om 3 times together. Rub your palms together, repeat the Shanti Mantra. May there be peace in the heavenly regions, intermediate regions, on the earthly plains, in water, in trees, in medicinal herbs. May the divine beings bless us. May the Supreme Lord be gracious on us. May there be peace everywhere. Om Dyo Shanti, Antariksham Shanti, Prithivi Shanti, Apas Shanti, Vanaspataya Shanti, Oshadaya Shanti, Vishvedeva Shanti, Brahma Shanti, Sarvam Shanti, Shantireva Shanti. Pass your positive energy in the easterly direction to everyone in the easterly direction, to everyone in the southerly direction, to everyone in the westerly direction, to everyone in the northerly direction, to everyone above your head, everyone below your feet, and onto yourself, head, forehead, eyes, ears, neck, chest, back, knees, bow down. I thank Dr. Devraji for taking a lead on promoting health and wellness across the globe. The 100 projects, 100 days, 100 projects he has initiated, and he's been supported by very efficient yogis. Thank you, our Sri Raviji, our Vinayji, and thank you for coordinating and make this event successful. And you all have worked very hard, and I commend your efforts, and I thank all the participants who could able to attend this one. And Hari Om, thank you very much. Namaste.
Thank you. Sir, it is a great I think that you started project number 1 and you are in project number 100 today. We have initiated mini project number 100 with Indo-Malaysian Yoga Festival, and you are the initiator and the ideation and also the guidance for the mini projects from Rotary Bangalore Global Yoga. Now, at this point of time, I also have to tell that Rajendra sir is a true Rotarian in the means to say that he also teaches the Vasudeva Kriya Yoga in the prison and also to the orphanages. And he is also a true Rotarian when it comes to helping out the underprivileged people. Thank you very much, sir, for being an honorary Rotary member in our club. Thank you very much. Viewers, you can also connect with us for the Vasudeva Kriya Yoga with Rajendra sir in our Facebook commenting. So we will connect with Rajendra sir so that we can take this Vasudeva Kriya Yoga world over. It has also been seen that Vasudeva Kriya Yoga has also opened its branch in